Hello, everyone. Welcome to Hardline. I'm your host, Susanne Posel. Tonight is May 20th, 2015. On tonight's show, we have lots of great stuff for you, including an interview with Paul the Trombonist. He is an incredible songwriter, and he has this amazing song that I heard on YouTube about student loans. We'll play a clip for you later in the broadcast and talk to Paul about what inspired him to speak out about the indentured servitude, otherwise known as student loans. Hey everyone, welcome back. As promised, my special guest tonight is Paul the Trombonist. Paul is a Los Angeles-based music producer, songwriter, performer, educator, filmmaker, and of course, acclaimed trombonist. You can visit his website, paulthetrombonist.com. You can read his bio. You can watch videos. Among his many accomplishments since his teenage days playing with his own group at a jazz club in Cleveland, Paul has created an internet show called Bone Masters, where he interviews living trombone legends and conducts master classes with them. It's amazing stuff. I've watched a few episodes. Paul caught my attention after an audience member posted one of his music videos up on my Twitter feed. This is a song that he wrote about the enslavement of our college class. The YouTube video is called Mind-Blowing Student Loan Facts, and it is worth watching. My children loved it. I think it's fantastic. I want to play you a clip from the song because it's not only factually accurate, but it is extremely creative. Enjoy.
All right, here we go. Tuition is a high, your income is a low. You worked really hard, you really want to get inside a company. You have no choice, you gotta go to school. It's time to get a loan and borrow some money. The funny thing is that the program was designed to keep you at their mercy in a giant slave. Sign the line.
I have with me Paul the Trombonist. He is joining me tonight to speak about the song that we played. So, Paul, I want to thank you so much for coming on the show tonight.
Oh, thank you. It's an honor to be here.
Thank you. First off, the YouTube post, Mind-Blowing Student Loan Facts, is absolutely incredible. It's a fantastic song to listen to, and it's factually accurate, which I appreciate as a journalist. What inspired you to write this piece?
Okay, well, let's start back to when I was going to college. I went to a music school. I got some scholarships, but it didn't cover everything, so I had to take out a loan. It's kind of an expensive school, so that is a little bit of history. And, you know, I didn't think too much of it because I just wanted to focus on practicing and just learning music. And then, you know, once I graduate, then all the reality strikes you. So I interacted with these loan companies and, you know, everything was pretty cool and stuff. But I noticed that a lot of the fine print is not laid out to you. And I kind of wanted just to get the information out there so a younger generation or other people that were interested in taking out loans would kind of get a little bit of a heads up before they made any decisions, you know?
Absolutely. Are you a Gen Xer or a millennial?
A millennial.
You're millennial. I noticed that with the millennial generation, there's a lack of, like, purchasing homes. It's much easier to rent the house than it is to purchase and go through the garbage with the banks. And I'm assuming I'm a Gen Xer, so I went to school many, many years ago, and it was extremely expensive back then. And I did take out as little of the Pell Grant as possible in order to do that. But how do you see the millennial generation as far as taking out loans, and what is the precautions that the generation you think is taking?
Well, what I've noticed from my peers is a lot of them are in big trouble. They weren't quite sure what they're getting themselves into, and I always thought that it might be a good idea if when anyone was signing up for a loan that they should be required to sit down with the loan advisor and go through kind of like an overview of what they're getting themselves into and what the monthly payments would be once they graduate. how much they're going to need to make, how much the payments are going to be, how much interest they're going to end up paying. And, you know, it was so easy for me to get these loans. I just remember going on the computer and I just like electronically signed my name. And then all of a sudden, whatever my wish was granted, whatever amount I wanted was just in the bursar's check office at the college, you know. And I was young, you know, I was like, you know, 18 years old. I just feel like a lot of people didn't get that direction when they were signing up for these loans. They just gave them out so readily. I mean, it's basically a lot of kids, you know, they just got out of high school. They don't know what's going on with loans and how they work. And they easily just give out these loans to anyone. So then they get slapped with these huge fees and all these little fine print ways that these companies make money that aren't really kind of laid out for everyone. And I feel like they're kind of taking advantage of everyone. So all my friends, a lot of them, because a lot of them went to expensive colleges as well. And a lot of them are having a lot of issues, a lot of problems with them.
I understand that. Absolutely. Because the payback is really where it is. And you made a good point. We have to know how much money we have to earn in order to live. And on top of it, pay back the loan and the interest. And are we paying on the interest only? When do we get to the principal? Did you consider this song an act of activism?
Well, I just wanted to kind of make people aware. And I guess I have like a little bit of a following with the younger musicians and stuff. And I know a lot of them want to go to music school. And I just kind of wanted to make everyone a little bit aware of what they might be getting themselves into, and other people as well, you know.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's very important. I don't think that, well, I wasn't taught in school how the business world works. I got a paralegal degree, and that's when I learned how the business world works. And it's unfortunate that I had to pay to go to college in order to learn exactly how everything works and how what my place in it is as well. And as a journalist, bringing forth factual information, I think, is important so we can make an informed decision. If we want to go ahead and borrow as much money as possible, at least we're making an informed decision if we have the information. The details in the lyrics were very well researched. How many different sources and where did you go to get all of this information?
Oh, well, thank you. I went to a lot of different sources. I read The Student Loan Scam, The Most Oppressive Debt in History. It's a great book by Alan Kullinge. And I also went to a lot of like business insider sites, so the Wall Street Journal, Rolling Stone articles. There's in the YouTube link, I cite all the sources on the YouTube link. And that kind of was an eye-opener. And the more I was researching, the more I was finding out that things could have been organized a little bit better. I think the intention started off good to get people to go to college, you know, at a reasonable route for them to take. And I think what ended up happening, you know, is just people got greedy and everyone, you know, it became like a business and they're trying to find the way to make the most profits. And now it needs a little bit of another direction, maybe, I think.
I agree with that one, absolutely. Do you think the quality of the education fits the bill, the cost of it?
Oh, well, I went to Berklee College of Music, which is the best music school in the world, one of them, and I had an amazing education. So I'm very satisfied with my education, and it definitely opened a lot of doors to me, and I made a lot of contacts. And luckily, I didn't have to pay the full tuition because I had scholarships, but it still was expensive, and I'm still going to be paying my loans for a while. One of the things that kind of is interesting about working with like companies like, I guess, Navient is what Sallie Mae used to be. They now refer to themselves as Navient. Is they say, this is what you got to pay. And then you try to work with them and then they figure out other ways to tack on hidden fees and stuff like that. So I don't know.
Tell the audience, I know that you have an internet show called Bone Masters. Tell the audience about that, because I watched a couple of episodes. It was very informative, and I don't know how to play the trombone, so I have to defer to you. You do a wonderful job. What inspires you to do that show? And you also teach people how to play the trombone.
Yeah, basically, I kind of have two things online going on. I have Paul the Trombonist, which is originally produced material where I'll do current pop tunes or current other types of genre tunes and maybe feature guests and arrange them in an original way or write my own material, which is the student loan song is a part of that. And then I also do a show called Bone Masters, where I'm documenting all the greatest living trombone players of our time period and doing master classes with them. And so I kind of do both of those things simultaneously at the moment. And you can see them all on my YouTube channel called Paul the Trombonist. They're all on there. Or on Facebook, Paul the Trombonist Fans is where I do my originally produced material. And Bone Masters TV, that Facebook page is where I put up the videos for the master classes.
I love it. I've gone to both sites, paulthetrombonist.com as well, folks. Thank you for coming on the show today. And thank you for writing that song.
Oh, I appreciate it. It means a lot to me.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Dan.
Well, folks, that's my show tonight. I hope you enjoyed Paul the Trombonist. I did. Please go to his YouTube channel and listen to some of the other songs. They're incredible. This guy is amazing. And I want to reiterate some of the points that I made earlier today. It is important that when we purchase products, that we make sure that we're getting what we think we're getting, and we don't fall for marketing tactics. When they say below detectable levels, they just mean you can't detect it. And it doesn't mean that you're not being poisoned. It just means you don't know how much. And over time, 20, 30 years from now, you might not think that it was the water filter that gave you cancer or contributed to your receiving cancer. You thought the filter was filtering out the toxins because you listened to the marketing. You didn't hear that one sentence, that legal disclaimer that they have to give, that they lower it to below detectable levels. The other fact that I wanted to bring up is when we talk about farming and we talk about wanting to create profit from our food supply, we have to accept the fact that some places in this country are changing. And if we don't, then we were at the mercy of our governors and the people who pay for them to be in office to take care of those problems. And we know, at least from Nestle, one corporation that is an example, that we don't want to leave that kind of decision in the hands of them, especially with what's going on with the USDA and Monsanto. We absolutely do not want to leave that decision up to the corporations because they will choose profit over people every single time. And if we want to change what's happening, really change it, we can't go into suppositions and have a belief system and faith. We have to actually get real facts and evidence to prove who's doing it, what, where, why, and how. That's my show tonight. I hope you enjoyed it. I had a great time. I will see you in a couple of days. And as always, take care.
Listening to AmericanFreedomRadio.com, the network who perseveres in delivering intelligent debate, constructive dialogue with true independence. The freedom to broadcast the truth is not free at all. So what is American Freedom Radio worth to you? The empowering information with fun, honest and pure integrity behind it provides an example to follow. Friendships to flourish with the moral altruism that pulls no punches. The hosts sacrifice and show remarkable discipline in their duty to deliver quality radio in service to the community with strength, wisdom, and loyalty. The founders of AFR wish to thank you personally for sharing your views and insights to make the best radio and alternative media. Now it's time for you to give something back and play a vital role in the future of America. Be as generous with us as we've been with you. Click on the donate banner at AmericanFreedomRadio.com or volunteer by emailing AmericanFreedomRadio.com. Vaccines, psychotropic drugs, and artillery batteries not included.
Do you realize every day we are being put under constant stress from wireless radiation? What's worse is that you don't even know that it's happening. It puts as much stress on our body as if we had a constant viral infection, draining our energy and sapping our strength, or just making us irritable and fatigued. These wireless fields are being emitted from computers, microwaves, mobile phones, power lines, and any electrical appliance. Now there is a solution. A group of research engineers in New Zealand have come up with an active shielding device that shields you from wireless radiation at a cellular level. Blue Shield comes in three models: a household, portable, and USB that plugs into any computer. The great thing about Blue Shield is it is very affordable and guaranteed to last. A one-off purchase will see you being protected for years to come. Visit AmericanFreedomRadio.com and click on the Blue Shield banner. Blue Shield, brought to you by the VinnieEastwoodShow.com.
Now you and your family and friends can enjoy the cleanest, most delicious, and healthy drinking water anytime, even while traveling, camping, at sporting events, or in emergency situations. The Berkeleyte removes bacteria, cysts, parasites, and harmful chemicals to below detectable levels. It also reduces nitrates and unhealthy minerals like lead and mercury, while leaving in the beneficial and nutritional minerals your body needs. Berkeleyte is so powerful, it can even purify raw, untreated water from remote lakes and streams. And the optional PF2 filters even remove fluoride. The Berkeleyte LED, with its rechargeable lighting system, can be used as a nightlight or a camp light. To view or purchase your Berkeley water system and replacement filters, please visit American Freedom Radio's website at AmericanFreedomRadio.com and click the Berkeley banner. Once again, that's AmericanFreedomRadio.com, and click the Berkey Water banner.
We are living in a new era. Partnerships are more important than profit, and gratitude is more respected than greed. As the millennial generation evolves the corporate landscape, our company aims to maximize the achievements of CBD application and push the limits of what's possible by 2020. Our core product matrix and careful cannabidiol purification process are uniquely designed to be privately made in different regions of the world and is geared to assist the efforts of different nations to change the landscape of various pain-related healthcare costs, epilepsy and autism, rising mental disorders, and even soldier suicides. Crystal Pure CBD is made with the industry's finest 99.9% pure CBD crystals. No paste, no filler. Our solution is a permanent answer, and it saves you over one-third in cost. Crystal Pure CBD. Come join us.
No rules. No rules. No taboo topics. No taboo topics. No fear of doom. No fear of doom. We are American Freedom Radio. American Freedom Radio.